Okay, so I'm about to take this beautiful makeup off, but I was just thinking, I'm fucking terrified to actually become a social worker slash therapist. Yeah, I wouldn't say terrified per se. I'm just a little nervous. I'll say that. It's three main things that I've thought of so far. I'm pretty sure some more shit gonna come up, but for right now, it's just three things. Ooh, this smell good. Shit. So, the first thing, I'm not really sure if I can control like my facial expressions, my reactions to shit. You know, now because of COVID, we wear masks. So like my full facial expressions are often covered. So nobody can really see the shit. But I need to get better at not reacting to things or what people say. Because sometimes even in class and we're on Zoom, sometimes I have to turn my camera off when people say certain shit. That's just like, bitch, why you say that? I'm just gonna say, it's certain people I go to school with that have no business being a fucking social worker. I'm gonna put that out there right now. It's the people I'm in class with, and they're just like, bitch, you sure this is what you wanna do? I noticed at my internship, I don't really have that big of a problem, so I probably shouldn't be worried about it. It's mainly just at school when they talk about shit, it's probably never gonna happen, but they have to give you like every scenario in the world. But my internship, I could think, okay, this person is like 78 years old. They're thinking it's like 1943. So I could kind of, you know, put myself in their shoes, like, okay, yeah, I'm just worried about that. I'm just worried, you know, I want to come off as unprofessional because I can't control how I react to certain shit. Or sometimes stuff that I think about just come out my goddamn mouth. Like, you know, something fucked up happened. Damn, you know, well, I'm trying to learn how to, you know, I can think that, you know, damn, it's fucked up, but no, not to say it. My second thing kind of goes into my reactions because I'm fucking scared to work with kids. For context, I don't have kids. I'm not really around kids like that. When I was growing up, I guess I was around kids, but I wasn't responsible for them. I didn't have to take care of them. I didn't have to, you know, socialize with them. That's one of the things I'm terrified of, is actually working with kids, because I'm like, how do I communicate and connect with tiny humans, you know? I'm about to put on this Noxzema Classic Cream, so I'll be looking kind of questionable for a minute. When I first started college, I majored in early childhood education so I could be a preschool teacher. Obviously that didn't work out. You know, when I was doing my observations and I was, you know, doing the book work and taking tests, it was fine. As soon as I got in that classroom, Lord Jesus. Lord. Because kids have no damn filter. They let your ass know if you suck. And of course, I'm just starting out, so they didn't say anything like I sucked or anything like that. It was just, I was like, do I really want to be in a classroom full of kids all damn day? So that's one of my fears going into the social work field, because obviously therapy is gonna be one of the aspects. Counseling, if I work for Child Protective Services, you know, I'll be dealing with kids. I have to talk to them and see what's going on.
Can you tell me what happened to your mommy? My mama and my daddy was fighting last night, and my daddy started choking her like, bitch, 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 you smoked all the crack rock. And my mama was like, Marcus, I can't breathe. And then she fell on the floor.
I'm not sure how to get on a child's level and communicate and to make them feel comfortable talking to me. Hell, I barely even know how to do that with adults. You know, I've had friends who have kids. And, you know, they just tell me,
oh, you just talk to them like you talk to anybody else.
Well, bitch, I can't because I curse. You know, I use foul language. I talk about shit that kids don't need to be talking about or hearing. The last thing that I thought of was, what if I just don't have the capability to help any fucking body? I talked to my therapist about this because I'm like, you know, I have a mental health disorder. I have days when I can't even function. How can I help somebody else do that same shit when I can barely keep myself together? You know? And she brought up a great point. She was like, yes, you can help other people even though you're going through your own shit. Because she didn't say shit. That's me. I'm paraphrasing. You're a human being. And of course you got your own stuff. But you can always help other people with their stuff. I'm like, okay. And I get it. Because when I'm at my internship, you know, I have to help people all day. And I would like to say I'm good at doing that. I try my best. And I give 100%, you know, when my clients come to me and they have issues, of course, I consult with my supervisor and let her know what I think I should do. And, you know, she confirms or tells me, well, maybe we should handle this a different way. But at the end of the day, we're still helping the client. And it's okay if I need help helping other people. But yes, I'm still kind of terrified. That fear still sits in the back of my head. Like, bitch, you can't even help yourself. How you gonna help somebody else? And I should not be thinking like that because that's not true. Okay, now I need to wash my face. So yeah, those are the three concerns that I have about becoming a social worker. And I wanted to share that with you all because, yeah, I just like being vulnerable on camera, I guess. But yeah, if y'all have any advice or, you know, anything, just let me know down below. I'm in my second semester now. Actually, it's gonna be springtime. And it's not any better than the first semester. But this semester, I told myself, look, don't act like a grad student. I know that sounds weird, but first semester, I kind of went into grad school with these, you know, expectations. And I realized I didn't have to do that. Just be a normal ass student. Still give you 100%. Just don't be an overachiever like your ass was trying to do last semester. Because you ain't got to do all that. I'm going to wash my face now. And then do my normal night routine. And then that'll be it. I just want to come on and share my thoughts with you guys. So thank you for listening.